A very good morning, class 12. So here we are again with our English core class. So we have already started with the chapter Law Spring from the book Flamingo. And I'm really, really hoping that you are liking it, our chapter, because it talks about how the young children, they have lost their childhood days, those who belong to the poor category, the poor strata basically, and they just want to support their family in earning the money. So you're learning something new, that what's the value of the childhood as well as the education here. So let's see, now we are here on the second part of the story. I want to drive a car, right? So this story is about a boy named Mukesh. So earlier the first part was of Sahib Alam. This is of Mukesh, who used to live in the place called Firozabad. And they were busy in making bangles. So Sahib Alam's story was of rag picker, and Mukesh's story, who lived in Firozabad, who used to make the bangles, right? So the title of this short story is, I Want to Drive a Car. So means a boy who was very young in age, who was caught in the bangle industry forcefully or just to support the family, but his dreams were totally different, right? So here I'm going to read it for you. Mukesh insists on being his own master. I will be a motor mechanic, he announces. So when Mukesh met Anish Jung, the author, he said that he want to be his own master, as it's written, and he want to be a motor mechanic. He want to learn how to drive a car. Do you know anything about cars? Author asked from him. I will learn to drive a car. So see how he was determined. He knew that he did not belong to that category, but still he was very determined to learn to drive a car. Looking straight into my eyes, that is author's eyes, his dream looks like a mirage amidst the dust of streets that fill his town, Firozabad. Now this line is also very interesting. Mirage here means which is very difficult to achieve. Right, not able to achieve it properly. So basically it means that his dream, it looks like that it's the unachievable one. Why? Because he used to live in the dust of street, basically when he used to live in that bangle industry. Famous for its bangles. Every other family in Firozabad is engaged in making bangles. It is the center of India's glass blowing industry, where families have spent generations working around furnaces, wielding glasses, making bangles for all the women in the land, it seems. So means the people, those who were living in the Firozabad, from number of years, like from generations, those people were engaged only in one work, that is bangle industry. Now here in this para as well as in the next para, you will get to know even the drawbacks. Now there is one very important question which comes here, basically the drawbacks of the working in the bangle industry, or we can even say the disadvantages or the hazards of working there. That also we will discuss it, right? So it says, Mukesh's family is among them. None of them know that it is illegal for children. So means Mukesh's family was also involved in this work. And the people, those who were working there, the children, those who were working there, basically people were unaware of this part, that working, the young children can't work actually. Those families were unaware of it. Yes. Basically, you know, there is a law that it is illegal. Child labor is not allowed. But still people are indulging those things. So here the family was unaware of this part. Like him, to work in the glass furnaces with high temperatures. Now this is very important to mark it here. In high temperatures, in dingy cells, that is the small cells without air and light, that the law, if enforced, could get him and all those 20,000 children out of the hot furnaces where they slogged their daylight hours, often losing the brightness of their eyes. Underline, this is very important. Like the children, they're working in these small, dingy cells, dark rooms where there's high temperature because they're working in the furnaces. Fire is there. And they need to work just close to their eyes while making those bangles. Hot temperature is there. So if that Mukesh and other 20,000 children, if they will come out from that situation, that would be beneficial, happy. But unfortunately, what happened with these children, they are losing the brightness of their eyes. So mark it here, as I said, the hazards of working in bangle industry. First, as it's mentioned, losing the brightness of the eyes. Or next point, we can write it, partial blindness. Please write it in your register, partial blindness. Next can be the breathing problems or the respiratory problems. Then another hazard or the disadvantages here, skin cancer, burning of the skin, lung cancer. So there are a number of points which you can write for this answer, and this is one of the important question too. Okay, so let's see what happens next here. It says about Mukesh eyes beam as he volunteers to take me home, which he proudly says is being rebuilt. So Mukesh was very happy to take Anish Jung to his place, and he said it is going to rebuild. So here in the next few lines, there is a description about Firozabad area. Remember in the earlier story, we have discussed about Simapuri area too. Now Firozabad area, that what kind of pity condition there was. So you need to see, we walked down stinking lanes choked with garbage. So there was a lane, garbage was there. Past homes that remained hovels with crumbling walls. Walls were in broken condition. Wobbly doors, unstable doors, no windows, crowded with families of humans and animals coexisting in primeval state. Now this is important. Humans and animals, they all were living together in the same house, same place, as it used to happen in the earlier stages, earlier life, right? He stops at the door of one such house, bangs a wobbly iron door with his foot. So he stops there. With his foot, he pushed the banged that door. We enter a half-built shack. Now, half-built shack is which has been constructed by Oon with whatever material they were available of that. In one part of it, thatched with dead grass, in a fire is a firewood stove over which sits a large vessel of sizzling spinach leaves. So when enter, one side there was a stove and there was a food was prepared on that. On the ground, in large aluminium platters, are more chopped vegetables. And on the ground, it seemed that the food was getting prepared. A frail young woman, the frail is the delicate one, human, is cooking the evening meal for the whole family. Through eyes filled with smoke, she smiles. She is the wife of Mukesh's elder brother. Means Mukesh's elder brother's wife was there, who was preparing the food. Not much older in years, but still she was the bahu of that, the daughter-in-law of that house. Already in charge of three men, because her husband used to live there, Mukesh, and their father used to live there. So the and daughter-in-law as well as Mukesh's grandmother too. When the older man enters, she gently withdraws behind the broken wall and brings her veil close to her face. As custom demands, daughter-in-laws must veil their faces before male elders. So Anish Jung mentioned she was sitting there, but as soon as the elder entered, she covered her face. Because there is a custom, you need to cover your face when someone elder male especially enters. In this case, the elder is an impoverished bangle maker. Despite long years of hard labor, first as a tailor, then a bangle maker, he has failed to renovate a house. So then Anish Jung said that this bangle maker who was living in that poor condition, first he was a tailor, then changed his profession, working in that profession from a very longer period of time, but unfortunately not able to have that sufficient money, not even able to renovate a house properly. Send his two sons to school. All he has managed to do is teach them what he knows, the art of making bangles. So the only one thing which he did, Mukesh father, he taught his sons how to make the bangles. That is the only thing. So still, till here only we are covering up. The next portion from here, we will do it in the next class. So if you are still having any doubts, You can raise it, you can ask it, and send the worksheet timely without any delays. Thank you and God bless you all.